Hi, this is May, Marcy Mom from EczemaBlues.com. Today I'm sharing with you about allergy testing for kids. Why allergy test? It can help us parents to figure out the allergen that is triggering our child's eczema. As I always say, allergy testing saves me from the verge of paranoia. At one point, I was even thinking whether the chair that my child is sitting on is causing her eczema. Now let's understand a little bit more about allergy test. Allergy test can help us to figure out the allergen that is triggering the allergic response. Depending on the form of the response, it leads to different allergic conditions. So for eczema, also known as atopic dermatitis, the response is a skin rash due to the allergen, which is a microscopic protein. The most common allergy test is the skin prick test. My daughter had done it at 7 months old. She didn't cry at all. It can be paint-free or very little paint if it's done properly by someone experienced. It's a quick prick to introduce the allergen under the skin. It is fast, cheap, and reliable. You also need a experienced doctor to interpret the results. What happens is about 30 minutes after the prick, including a prick which is a control prick, small bumps will appear, known as wheals, on the skin, and where this wheal exceeds a certain size, it will be determined that that allergen is what your child is sensitive to. To do the skin prick test, a clear patch of skin is required. And as parents, we should not give our child any antihistamine within a week from the date of the skin prick test. The other common test is the blood IgE test, which is a test to measure the antibodies known as the immunoglobulin E in the blood. So these antibodies can be tagged to specific allergens. So if there are a lot of such antibodies for that allergen, it signals that your child is allergic to that, because her body is creating a lot of antibodies to counter that allergen. A blood IgE test is more expensive and the results are within the week, so it cannot be, you have to go back for repeat consultation. It is suitable for those without clear patch of skin and or for patients who have to take antihistamine. I understand there are also allergy tests that can be bought from the internet, or allergy tests that are less reliable. These are not recommended. And now we share a little bit more about the allergens that are tested for. Now, before I go for the allergy test with my child, I was thinking that, I'm already thinking about like 100 items that she could be allergic to. Does that mean that she will be pricked 100 times? Fortunately, the answer is no. There are common allergens, and these common allergens cover about more than 80% of what the children would normally be allergic to. So doctors have an understanding of the kind of common allergens for different age group, for different patient profile. So the common food allergen is cow's milk, egg, peanut, wheat, and soy. For non-food is pet dander and dust mite. Also pollen. In Singapore, pollen allergy is not common, but in other countries it is. So it could be included as in the first skin prick test. When do you ask your doctor to give the child an allergy test? It could be when your child do not respond to treatment, or you suspect a certain allergen and you discuss this with the doctor. When do you take another allergy test after the first one? It could be repeated after 6 months to see if your child has outgrown certain food, so that you could add those food back into the child's diet. It could also be when there is a new allergic condition. For instance, instead of rashes, you start sneezing, wheezing. So then you can discuss with your doctor if another allergy test should be taken. Technically, allergy tests can be taken for any age group, but for children who are below 6 months old, the test results is not accurate and therefore is not recommended. what are the not to's with regard to allergy test? One is to make your own test. The allergy test, that for instance, the skin prick test, the solution is specially prepared, so it's not just taking a banana and putting it under the skin. The other more important reason not to try allergy testing on your own at home is because if there is a severe reaction, like an anaphylactic reaction, then an EpiPen needs to be administered immediately. It is for this reason that oral food challenge, which is the gold standard in determining if there is food allergy, is always done in hospital setting. Don't try to interpret the allergy test yourself. And the reason is, it's important to have an experienced doctor interpret that result and then go through with you what is the next step. So now, for instance, you can discuss with your doctor. Don't be shy about it and just ask, so these are the items that my child is allergic to. I'm going to avoid them. And then how should the skin look? Or along with the prescription that your doctor give, how should the rashes look after 2 weeks? If it looks worse or if it still looks the same after how many weeks, should I then come back or ask for an earlier appointment? Don't be afraid to ask questions like that with your doctor. The other thing is not to overdo elimination diet. Don't try to remove too much food from the child's diet unless it is he or she is tested allergic to it. Don't unnecessarily restrict your child from such food. If you are removing certain foods, do check with a nutritionist or to find out alternative foods to replace that nutrition. If you like this and you'd like to find out more, do go to my blog, eczemablues.com/tag/allergy-test, where I interview many experts on this topic. Thank you very much for listening and see you next time.